Hello students, this is your chemistry class and today's class we are going to solve the worksheet from organic chemistry. So let's continue the class. So we have already discussed up to question number 9 and next question is question number 10. That is, give example of an ambidextrous nucleophile. Now the question is, what is ambidextrous nucleophile? Ambidextrous nucleophiles are those nucleophiles that can attack by utilizing their two sides. Suppose I am asking about giving an example of ambidextrous nucleophile is CN minus. So this CN minus is an ambidextrous nucleophile. Why? Because sometimes it donates through its carbon center. From its carbon center, and sometimes it donates from its nitrogen center. So sometimes the attachment is like, suppose I am asking about CH3CA. So here the connection is between this carbon and this carbon, like this. And sometimes it can also happen, this one is cyanide. It can also exist as isocyanide, that is CH3NC. So here you can see the linkage is between this carbon atom and this nitrogen atom. That means cyanide is able to attack or donate by utilizing both its carbon center and nitrogen center. That's why it is termed as ambidextrous nucleophile. Another ambidextrous nucleophile exists, that is thiocyanate. Sometimes it utilizes its sulfur center, and sometimes it utilizes its carbon center. Okay, so thiocyanate, HCl minus, sometimes it utilizes nitrogen center and sometimes it utilizes sulfur center. Thiocyanate and cyanide both are ambidextrous nucleophiles. So what are ambidextrous nucleophiles? Those who are able to utilize its more than one attacking center, those who have more than one attacking center and they can utilize them, that one are ambidextrous nucleophiles. Okay, so next question is question number 11. It is saying about geometrical isomerism, that is two structures are given and you have to identify which one can exhibit geometrical isomerism. The given structures are number 11, CH3CH3CBr2 double bond CBr2 and BrCH double bond CH, CH2CH3. So the question is, which one can exhibit geometrical isomerism? Identify those isomers. So the geometrical isomerism, general geometrical isomerism, are cis trans isomerism, and you have to identify which one can exhibit cis and trans form. So if I write the structure like this, C double bond C, H, CH3, Br. And you know, according to the rules of cis trans isomerism, this if this carbon atom bears to same group, then it cannot exhibit any geometrical isomerism. But here in this structure, Br, CH2CH3. So you can say that these two hydrogen atoms are on same side, so they are cis in nature. So this isomer, this molecule can exhibit geometrical isomerism. One is cis given and the trans structure is C double bond C, H, H, CH2CH3, Br. So here two hydrogen atoms are trans. So cis and trans are two geometrical isomerism that are shown by this structure. But this structure, as this carbon atom has two same groups, two bromine groups are same on a carbon atom, and this does not maintain the criteria for geometrical isomerism. That's why it cannot exhibit geometrical isomerism. Next question is that what type of isomerism is shown by the compounds with molecular formula C3H6? Question number 12. C3H6. So the linear chain form is CH3CH double bond CH2. That is simple propene. So this one is C3 and 3 plus 2 plus 1, that is 6. C3H6, that is the one form of propene. And how many structures you have to find? How many structures are possible for this molecular formula? Formula will be given. And you can also think about ring structures, okay? How many structures are possible you have to identify, and then you have to correlate in the given structure. So this is the one open chain form. So in the chain form, what is the structure possible? So if you write simple cyclopropane, okay, cyclopropane, so in this cyclopropane you can identify there are three carbon atoms, so C3, and each carbon atom bearing two hydrogen atoms for maintaining the valency of carbon, so C3H6. So the you have to identify or think about all the possible structures for the molecular formula C3H6, and we are able to find only two possible structures. That one is simple open chain from propene and cyclic from cyclopropane. Okay, only these two structures are possible. Now you correlate between these two structures. Between the structures you have to correlate what are the isomerism they are exhibiting. So you can easily identify this one is ring and this one is chain. So this falls under the category of ring chain isomerism. Okay, C3H6, ring chain isomerism, propene and cyclopropane. So remaining questions we will discuss in the next class.